Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters in Islam. You're tuning into this video which will inshallah explain to you the Quranic argument for the existence of God.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah to proceed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In a short clip, we're going to be discussing the Quranic argument for God's existence. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran in chapter 52 verses 35 to 36 specifically about the creation of the human being, the thing that began to exist, the thing that was originated. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, did you come from nothing? Did you create yourself? Did you create the heavens and the earth? بَلْ لَا يُقِّنُونَ. Indeed, rather they have no true faith, no true conviction. Now the Mufassirun, which means the scholars who did tafsir, did exegesis, did an explanation of the Quran, say that there are some logical explanations for things that begin to exist. Not just the human being, but everything that begins to exist. So let's apply this to the universe. Since we know the universe began to exist based on cosmology, based on mathematics, based on the concept of the infinity, we don't have to get into the technicalities. The universe began to exist. Then we could apply the four logical possibilities. And what are these four logical possibilities? Number one, it came from nothing. Number two, it created itself. Number three, it was created by something else created. Or number four, it was created by something uncreated. So let's do this quickly together. Number one, could it come from nothing? Well, let's look at this mathematically. 0 plus 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. No matter what you do with 0, no matter what you do with nothing, all you're going to get is 0, nothing. So we know the universe couldn't come from nothing. Well, could the universe create itself? Well, this is very interesting. Let me ask you a question. Could you give birth to yourself? Of course not, because that would mean that you were in existence and not in existence at the same time. Another question follows, did your mother give birth to herself? I mean, this is an impossibility. So we know self-creation is impossible because it would mean that the universe was in existence and not in existence at the same time. Impossible. Number three, could the universe be created by something else created? Well, this doesn't make sense, as the famous scholar Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah's mercy be upon him, said that you can't have an infinite regress of causes. Big language, I know, but what does it really mean? It basically means that how could a cause get its causal power from a previous cause? And that cause to get its causal power from a previous cause. If that goes on forever, you would never have the cause in the first place. You would never have existence. Let me make it very simple for you. Imagine I'm a little kid with a water gun and I want to spray my little brother. In order to spray my little brother, I have to ask permission from someone behind me. If that goes on forever, am I going to spray my little brother? No. So ultimately, we know that the universe couldn't have been created by something else created. So it leads to the final option, which is the best explanation, that the universe was created by something uncreated. But it doesn't mean it's God, it doesn't mean it's Allah, or any of the 4,000 names we've disagreed about since 6,000 BC Sumeria. But if we keep on using our minds, as the Quran says, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ, for those who use their brain and intellect, those who reflect, we continue this Quranic view, this Quranic approach, we can conclude some striking things. Number one, this uncreated creator must be powerful. There are billions of atoms in the universe. Split just one atom, you have an entire release of energy. An atomic explosion. So the creator, the uncreated creator, must be powerful. It must be intelligent or knowing. Why? Because it created laws in the universe like the law of gravity. And someone who creates a law implies a lawgiver. A lawgiver implies knowledge or intelligence. It must be transcendent. What does that mean? It means it must be outside of the universe, not made of the universe. As the Quran says, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There is nothing like unto him. For example, if I build a chair, do I become the chair? Of course not. The other perspective is that this uncreated creator must be eternal. Why? Because it's uncreated. If it's uncreated, it never began to exist. It's always been there. The other point is, this uncreated creator must have a will, meaning he must be able to have choice and be able to choose things to come into existence. Simple reason, because it's knowing and intelligent and eternal. and it brought into existence the universe that began. It can only mean it chose the universe to come into existence. Finally, as the Quran says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, say Allah is uniquely one. This uncreated creator must be one. You could sense this within yourself as part of your fitrah, part of your innate nature, your innate disposition, but also because it's the best and most comprehensive explanation. To say God is two or three is irrational, because it creates far more questions than it solves. Like, how on earth do two or three co-eternal beings coexist? It's irrational and doesn't add value to the explanation. So what we've done is we've summarized God's existence in just a couple of minutes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.